मैं युवा के। When Gurudev started his work, in the beginning it was all the discourses, Dhyan Yajnas, then the study groups, then Bal Vihar, then the schools and all that came. And in the year 1975, this idea of the Yuva Kendra also came. Yuva Kendra. Now see, Yuva Kendra specific emphasis may be on something, but the aim is the same. Remember, whether it is Bal Vihar or Yuva Kendra or the senior citizen program, the aim is on the same. Our transformation and what we can do for others. So, wow, can we serve? That's only the aim. So here, first I will just clearly the difference between the Bal Vihar and the Yuva Kendra. You see, in Bal Vihar, it is called Samskar Pradhan in the Bal Vihar. Samskar Pradhan means predominantly, prominently, primarily, it is focused on inculcating some samskars. Without much explanations or all those things. With good values, virtues, habits, manners, everything that is inculcation of that. But in Yuva Kendra, it is vichar pradhan. Samskar is vichar. Because you should know what you are supposed to do, but also why. Anyway, man's tendency is always to why. You ask this question so much. So they ask so many questions. In Hindi I had seen two volumes speak me. And its title was Why? We also bring kingdoms, Maharaj. Why do we do this in Indian culture? Frequently asked questions on Hinduism. So everything will go on, why? Sometimes the other person, why not? All the time ask you, why? Why should I do puja? Or why you should not do puja, tell me now. Why you should not do that? Anyway, so many of why? But you are Kendra. Is that one motto of the mission is already given to give maximum happiness? Then what the motto of these? Yuva Kendra. So, Pooja Gurudev already given. What is that? Tell me. Harnessing youth potentials through dynamic spirituality. Memorized? So now we had given the motto, give maximum happiness. Then you give the vision statement. Now one job is there for you. You have to write a statement for the Yuva Kendra. Exercise. Sanjay, when you have to submit it? Maybe tomorrow, because before it ends, our this conference ends, we must come up with that. Like how the mission statement to provide to individuals this land. So here, I give one or two lines like that, so that to empower the youth. And Yuva Kendra is meant for empowering youth. But empowering for what? To create riots. Right? No. Keeping our missions, vision, motto, everything in mind, then specifically what you have to do this, we'll see later on. Okay? So I will explain to you more about Yuva Kendra, then you can come up with a statement. Don't copy. But you can have mutual discussions, okay, and then. You see, practical application of this spirituality. What is that which we have to do in our life? Each one of us. Each one of us has to do only two things. One is called to face our life as it comes. And second is to make our life. To build our life. In that, there is our choice. See, how a life will come to me, on that I have no choice. Anything can happen anytime, or I don't know what will happen. That I don't know. But whatever happens, I have to face it. I can't just run away. And second thing is, I have to make my life, that there is a choice. What I want to do, what I want to be, that is in my hand. Like for example, you want to become a medical doctor, you want to become what, whatever you want. That's why they always ask you the question, what have you decided, what do you want to do? So that is your choice. So, to face that life as it comes, and also to make our life as we want to make, that is our job. Everybody has got that on. And to do this, we require motto. Because to face this life and to make, we will be able to do this only what our vision of life is, what our values of life are, and what all we are going to do. So therefore we say, to empower, we need empowerment to face this. Only on simple educational degrees and all that, we can't do everything. So, I had to face life, I had to build life, this is number one. Now, how I am going to do it? All these things I have to, how to do it? So, therefore it is said, harnessing youth potentials through dynamic spirituality. For achieving this, I will have to harness all my potentials. You see, in this motto, harnessing youth potentials through dynamic spirituality, the purpose is also understood. Because this is what is there, how I am going to do, for what purpose. All my potentials I have to harness. Like you know, in this nature's forces are there, so many things are there. Harnessing the forces of nature. For what purpose and how you are going to do. Isn't it? So three things are there. It is, all the forces are already there. But you have to harness and how you are going to do. See, the yogis will do in one way, rituals will do in one way, devotees will do in one way, all the scientists will do in one way, through scientific discoveries and technology and all that. So how you are going to, like wind energy, solar energy, so many other things happen. Is the door opened or locked? Is it open now or not? In one of you, who can sing here? Who can sing? Bhajan, what I mean. Are anyone who is sitting here, can't you just sing some Nama only? Sing. Achha, come on. Our topic was when we come to the practical aspect of spirituality, particular to you, actually this is common for all. A particular youth is more important because they are entering into their life actually. And isn't it true that when you, when you complete your education, so-called completion means you get degree, your real life begins then only. So what we need is how to empower ourselves to face our life successfully and also to build our life according to our dream, according to our vision. Nowadays we do find that people are getting into depression so very fast. The suicide rates also increasing so much. It's just growing. Why? Because that vision is not there. Huh? How to sustain ourselves, that is not there, not known. So that two aspects are there. And when everything goes wrong and all that, people go to all the different places to ask what their future is. One Mahatma said, don't go to even Mahatma's stone for asking your future, but go to make your future. Don't go asking. Now how will you do that? So the Chinmay Yuva Kendra, I sometimes, you know, when I meet with Yuva Kendra, I ask, if you join a medical college, what do you expect to become? Or simple, oh yeah, become a doctor. In the same way, engineer, lawyer. Then I ask, now when you join Yuva Kendra, what do you expect to become? I never thought about it. Then somebody say, better person, some say, perfect person, somebody say. So you want, must become a Chinmay Yuva, not become Jada Yuva, but Chinmay Yuva. In that, that you have a vision of life, you have got the values of life, and you have got very definite, what I call a plan of action. So you have empowered yourself to become that. That's what that is required. So, idea in this Yuva Kendra is now harnessing youth potential through dynamic spirituality. So as I was mentioning, like the nature forces and powers, they are already there. They can be harnessed in many ways and for different purposes also. You see, all the forces are there for destructive purpose or constructive purposes, for so many ways. All these scientific discoveries and technologies, you know, they are bringing so many changes in our life. So, in the same way, now youth potentials are also there already. Every person has potentials. No one is without that. And potentials are there with me that I will become aware of them, and I also for what purpose I have to make use of them and how I am going to do this. What are your potentials? Though if you say you have got physical potentials are there, you have got emotional potentials, mental are there, intellectuals are there, all these are potentials only. Do you know that two types of energy are called potential energy and other is what? Kinetic Honda. Kinetic energy also. So this will have to be turned into that. Now through spirituality, through dynamic spirituality, because about spirituality also person people think, you know, that's why Swamiji used the word dynamic. Because others say, I am spiritual, you know. Through dynamic spirituality. So this spirituality is what? It is a very big question. Huh? You have to think about it. Otherwise, you will repeat harnessing your potential through dynamic spirituality. What is the meaning of spirituality? What is the essence of spirituality? This much will I speak today now. You see, spirituality is not a kind of activity. It is not a particular activity. Even though people think like that, you know. See, he has become spiritual, you know, how he has joined an ashram. So whether he joined the ashram or you know, now he does pranayama. So, certain things you know that they do that is spiritual. So spirituality is not a particular activity. It is not doing something special. But it is a vision which gets reflected in every action that you do. How? Now so I ask him, you sing. So he sang, right? So singing is a special activity, particular activity. Okay? Now say, be honest. Being honest is a particular activity. Now say, show me how you dance. You can get up and show me and dance. Now show how you will be honest. Show. 2 minutes time I am giving you. Because honesty is not an activity. It is a value. Isn't it? So that value cannot be just performed in some particular activity like that. But that honesty will be seen in all thinking, feeling, action, behavior. It will be there all the time. This is clear, no? In the same way now, when we say spiritual, be spiritual. Spiritual means, so now what will I do? It cannot be a special activity like that. So what is the essence of all spirituality that we must know? I will just a few points that I will enumerate and then you know you can think of it. The one aspect of it is faith in something which is not directly seen by us materially, tangibly. That is one aspect of spirituality. Second aspect of that is that you do not become a beggar of happiness. In other words, your happiness does not depend upon the external thing. Then, the other thing is, what kind of relationship you feel with others? When you say it is a vision, it's vision of what? If all the time I have got a love-hate relationship with everybody, I love this person, I hate that person like snake. What, why should you hate snake also? So then there is something wrong. How I think, how I feel, how I act, there has to be some uniformity. So in the spirituality, there is also thinking, feeling and action. So thinking means knowledge. When there is a knowledge of that one truth or self or God is there in all beings, this knowledge, then the heart also filled with that love for all, and then that is translated into action also in the form of the service, then it is called a spiritual vision. It is not doing something special or particular. So put it this way also, spirituality is not doing something special, but doing everything in a special way. Everything in a special way, with this kind of knowledge, understanding, feeling, is called a spirituality. And this is, with this, we have to harness our potential. It is a very passive kind of, it is a pursuit of knowledge. It is a, what you call, a divinization of our emotions. And then it is called, or the spirit of service, that which comes in life. That is spirituality.